Hey, what's up? This is Dave from Revocation. Our new record, Nether Heaven, is coming out September 9th, and in honor of that, we're going to be partnering with KCBC to brew our very own beer. My man Tony's going to give us a tour of the brewery. Let's go check it out. So I'm here with Tony. He's the mastermind behind the brewery here, and he's going to give us a tour of the facilities, and we're going to check out the Nether Hellas beer that they're working on.
Hey, what's up? Glad you guys are here. It's our KCBC taproom. We're going to go walk through the brewery and look a little bit about the brewing process and talk about the making of this beer. Let's go. Hey, we're here in the back production space at KCBC. We're making Nether Hellas. Right here's the brew house area. So beer starts with taking malted barley and mixing it with water to make, essentially you're making sugar water. So if sacks of malt here, those get crushed, transferred over into this middle tank here where Brewer Ryan's actually taking out the grain that's already been soaked in water, and all that is ran off into the brew kettle. At that point, it's called wort. It's sugar water, and so he's now all the sugar's been pulled out of that. And it's not going to be used to make the beer.
Tony, do you ever go up to that steaming vat of wort right there and just get like a wort facial or anything like that? Just open up the pores or what?
For the pores. I mean, our brewing team here has got the smoothest skin in Bushwick. It's nonstop steam facial all day. After we pull all the sugar out of it, we've got a big steaming kettle of delicious wort. You know, boil it, add hops to it. It's gonna give some bitterness to the beer at the end of the boil. You're gonna add even more hops to it. It's gonna give really nice aroma and flavor to come from the hops late into the boil. And you know, it's gonna give us an awesome crisp Hellas lager. Once we're done boiling that wort, we gotta cool it down. Gotta get it down to about 70 degrees. And at that point, we're gonna put yeast in it and transfer it over into a fermenter where the magic really happens. We're gonna pump it over into one of these nice shiny tanks over here where it's gonna sit for 6 weeks and ferment. So all that sugar that was in the wort that was in the kettle, the yeast eat that up. It turned into alcohol and carbon dioxide. It tastes sweet right now. All that sugar is just gonna be eaten up, and then you end up with what beer is.
So I've known Tony for a few years now. I'm a huge fan of his beer. Why did you choose a Hellas for the Revocation beer?
Oh well, I mean, you know, the album's called Nether Heaven.
Got a hell theme.
Yeah, I mean, come on, Hellas Lager. It's in the name. So Hellas Lager is a nice, you know, crisp, light German style lager.
You're gonna need that when you're sweating your ass up in hell.
Yeah, and you're gonna need it at a show. You know, it's great beer drinking for you're gonna be in a crowd of people, you're gonna be in that pit working up a sweat. You need something to, you know, cool down. So, yeah, Dave and I have known each other for a few years. He's into craft beer. I'm into his band. I'm into everything heavy. So, you know, we're in Brooklyn and cross paths.
It just made sense.
Made sense. We've been talking about doing this for a couple of years now. So it was about time. So it was, you know, great timing.
And it's crushable, so you can drink
so crushable
multiple cans at the show. Circle pit, you get hot, you cool off, have another Hellas, go back for more, you know?
Drink it all.
All right, so Tony, tell me about some of the tasting notes of Nether Hellas.
I mean, I think the cool thing about a Hellas lager is it's a bright, smooth lager. Generally they're not as hoppy as like a Pilsner. So it's even easier drinking. You know, we really like it. I think it's just like a really, really crushable lager style.
We encourage shotgunning these beers too, you know, just so you can get them into your body as fast as possible.
It's not irresponsible, it's hydration. This is about 2 weeks old, 2 weeks after it was brewed. So we still got about 4 more weeks to go. So this beer's done fermenting. It's got as much alcohol in it as it's gonna have. 2 week old Nether Hellas.
Cheers.
Still a little yeasty. You know, it doesn't have that like crispness to it that it's gonna have once it's finished. But you can tell it's there. This Nether Hellas in its final form. This is it's like six weeks. This is a nice, beautiful, bright, crisp lager.
Breaking news.
Breaking news. Breaking booze.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, yeah.
You know, nice and clean. All that yeast has dropped out. The flavor's kind of, you know, rounded out. Yeah, this really highlights how it's different from a Pilsner. It's, you know, it's got like a smooth hop profile to it versus the extra bitterness you have from Pilsner. This could be shotgun worthy for sure. Their fermenters are bright tanks. So the bright tank is like a flat bottom vessel where we put the beer like at its final stages, and it's keeping it cold. And then once it's done fermenting, you're gonna drop the temperature down to 34 degrees, get a nice ice cold, just above freezing, and then you're gonna carbonate the beer. So once it's cold, get CO2 into that beer, get it nice and crispy and carbonated, ready to throw in some cans and kegs. This beer is actually a really simple beer recipe. It's a Weyermann Pilsner malt. It's really light colored Pilsner malt. Malt can be kilned or roasted to different levels, and so this is like really, really light, makes that nice, you know, crisp white looking beer. And then it's Zephyr hops and Hellertau hops. So use some Magnum hops for the bittering, and then Zephyr and Hellertau at the end of the boil, which really gives you flavor and aroma in it. So it's this nice, delicate, almost floral, little fruity aroma to it. It's gonna make it really easy to drink. People are gonna be able to get this at KCBC, all over New York City and New York State. We're gonna have it at Elsewhere for the show on September 13th. Revocation headlining, tons of other cool bands. Gonna be able to drink a ton of it there. If you live in New York State, we'll be able to ship it to you all over New York State. We'll have some cool, you know, cool merch stuff available to buy, and we can ship you cans. So go to kcbcbeer.com and we'll be able to get you beer.
Tony, thanks so much for showing us around, giving us a full tour. Yeah, make sure you pick up the new record, Nether Heaven, September 9th. Make sure you come to the Brooklyn show and try the Nether Hellas beer from KCBC. Cheers, man.
Cheers. You gotta work on that a little bit.
All right, you know, I'm not a brewery master, so.